वेलकम ऑल. टुडेज टॉपिक इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ चालुक्यास ऑफ बादामी इन आर्किटेक्चर. टेम्पल आर्किटेक्चर बिगैन विथ मड वॉल स्ट्रक्चर्स विथ स्टोन स्लैब रॉक्स. दीज मड वॉल टेम्पल्स डिड नॉट सर्वाइव फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड. Therefore, in the second stage, burnt bricks were used for the temple walls. In the third stage, brick-shaped stones were used for temple walls. There were stone pillars. Such temples were built between 200 BC and 600 AD. Rock-cut temples or cave temples were carved at Badami and other places since 6th century AD. Cave paintings belong to the earlier stage of civilization. Cave sculptures and temples belong to the later stage. In the history of Indian art, the Chalukyan art had a place of pride. Art critics have classified the various styles of Indian art as Nagara style, Vesara style and Dravidian style. Nagara style in north, Vesara style in Karnataka and Dravidian style in south were in vogue. The Chola and the Pallava temple can be cited as instance of Dravidian style. In the year 740 AD, Pallava kingdom was conquered by Vikramaditya of Badami Chalukyan empire. He brought famous Dravidian architect namely Sarvasiddhi Acharya and other from Kanchi to the Badami, the capital city of Chalukyas. They were appointed to construct a number of temples in Dravidian style. They also built some temples in Nagara style also in Pattada, Kallu and Aihole. These places became the cradle of Dravida and the Nagara styles of Hindu or Indian architecture. Temples of Virupaksha, Sangameshwara and others were built in with gopuras or towers in Dravidian style. They were main gate towers. The Shikara were built on the sanctum. Temples of Papanateshwara, Jambulingeshwara, Kalasiddheshwara, Galaganatheshwara were built with sanctum towers. Dravidian style were mainly built in the Vijayanagara period. The Bhuvaneshwara temple of Puri and Jagannath etc. are in Nagara style. The combination of these northern and southern temples form the Vesara style. This took birth in North Karnataka during the Chalukyan period. During Hoysala period, this style reached its zenith. The great art critic Percy Brown has called this region as the cradle of Indian temple architecture. Dr. Shivram Karant calls this period as the golden age of Karnataka art. Many buildings of the Chalukyan period are found in North Karnataka. The Shiva temple of Gokak, Mahalakshmi temple of Kolhapur can be cited as an instance of the early Chalukyan architecture. In the later period, they built many temples at Badami, Pattadakallu, Aihole, Lakkundi, Itagi. The cave temples were the places of worship in the beginning. Then started the structural monuments and with them the temple took birth. The Chalukyan temple in the beginning had flat or slightly inclined rooftops. In later phases, tower-like structural level appeared. Pillared hall was added to the four-walled Garbhagriha or sanctum where the deity is installed. This is an important development not to be found in Gupta architecture. Between Garbhagriha and the pillared hall, that is Stambha Mantapa, or an intervening hall was included. This again is an important development of the Chalukyan architecture. The Chalukyas built more than 100 temples. The famous among them were as follows. In Badami, Malagithi temple of Shiva, it is in Dravidian style. The Jain cave temples, the three Hindu cave temples, the Trimurti temple and the Banashankari temple is at the distance of 3 km from Badami. In Pattadakallu, Shiva temple, originally it was a Vishnu temple. The Papanateshwara temple, Mallikarjuna or Trilokeshwara temple, Virupaksha or the Lokeshwara temple. The Jambulingeshwara temple, it's in Nagara style. The Sangameshwara or the Vijayeshwara temple, it is in Dravidian style. In Aihole, the Durga Parameshwari temple, Meghuthi Jain temple, temple of Kali or Huchmalli, the Buddhist, Jain and Hindu cave temples, the Shiva temples built by Ranaraga at Mahakuta. The temple classification. Chalukyan temples can be classified as follows. The temples which are in Nagara style temples are Papanatha Temple, Jambulingeshwara Temple, Kala Siddheshwara Temple, Kashi Vishwanatha Temple. These temples are in Pattadakalu. And the other temple is Huchmalli Shiva Temple. It is in Haihole. The Dravidian style temples are Sangameshwara Temple, Virupaksha Temple, Mallikarjuna Temple. These temples are in Pattadakalu. And the Jain Narayana Temple or Yogi Narayana Temple is in Haihole. The main features of Chalukyan temples are some temples. Some of the main features of Chalukyan temples were simple and the small basement, square shaped sanctorium, that is idol chamber, interior Pradakshinapatha, central hall, Mukha Mantapa, Sukhanasi, that is entrance chamber, U-shaped basement in some temples, three sanctorium in some temples, 3 to 4 feet high platform of the temple. Some temples were carved in caves, not richly carved on walls or pillars, etc. The pyramid shaped towers. Some of the famous temples of this period are the Shiva temple, it's formerly known as Vishnu, or Ladkhan temple, it is in Haihole, Durgi or Kali temple in Haihole, Meghuti Jain temple, Badami cave temple, Durga Parameshwari temple and Virupaksha temple. First, let us learn few points about the Shiva or Vishnu temple. It's also called as Ladkhan temple. Shiva temple is one of the earliest temples built by the Chalukyas. Probably it was built in the middle of the 6th century AD. The tower must have been added to it later on. The lower tower lies not above the Garbhagriha or sanctorium but on the center of the temple. This temple throws light on the origin and the growth of Chalukyan temple, and the temple must have been built in the experimental stage. Its pillars are massive and rectangular in shape. Some of them are roughly heaven and circular, while some others are octagonal in shape. There are two Garbhagrihas or sanctorium built above the one which appears like tower. On the basis of the Garuda image carved on the main gate, art critic Henry Cousin is of the opinion that it must have been a Vishnu temple, but the Linga in the sanctorium and the Nandi have made it the Shiva temple. However, it is named after the Muslim saint Ladkhan, who took shelter for some time there. Next, let's learn about Konti temple. It is in Haihole. In local language, the word Konti stood for Trishula or Trident. There is a carving of Trishula and episodes of Shiva Purana in the Ranga Mantapa and the pillars. These pillars are richly carved and the sanctorium is empty as the Linga is stolen away. Next is Trikuta or Ramalinga temple. It is in Haihole. This was built on the side of Malaprabha river. There are three sanctuariums with images of Ramalingeshwara, Siddheshwara and Parvati. The three towers are in Dravidian style. This is the only temple in Haihole where worship is going on every day. The remaining about 125 temples are left out without worship. In most of these temples, there are no idols. Next is Durga Parameshwara temple, which is in Haihole. The Durga temple is an important one among Haihole temples. It seemed to have been imitated from the Buddhist and the Jain cave temples. The back view of the temple is semicircular. In other words, it is in the shape of horseshoe. In the center, one can see two columns of pillars and they extend beyond the sanctorium and end up in a semicircle. This has become the Pradakshinapatha for our devotees to go round the deity. The semicircular platform is supported by pillars. The tower above must have been a later addition. The structure of the temple indicates that perfection has not been attained in the building the temples at this stage. There are figures of Vishnu, Narasimha, Varaha, Garuda, Mahishasura Mardini on the walls of Rangamantapa. According to R.S. Panchamukhi, Durga temple was originally a Buddha Chaityalaya. Then it was converted into a Jainalaya, Vishnualaya and finally Durga temple. Next is Kali temple or Durgi temple. It is also known as the Huchmalli Temple. The Huchmalli Temple is a simple in construction and has no corridor around it. It has the small dimension and is built on the platform of 4 feet high. Its peculiar feature is that it faces the west and there is no ornamental work anywhere else except on the doors. Its tower is in Nagara style. It has a Shiva temple. It was a Shiva temple. Today there is no linga in the temple. A mad woman by the name Malli was staying here for some time. Therefore, it was called as Huchimalli temple. Next is Meghuti Jain temple. It is built at the very entrance of Aihole. It is a Jain temple built by Ravi Kirti, the court poet of Pulakeshi II. It has a sanctorium and two platforms. The famous Aihole inscription is carved on the eastern wall. The two garbhagrihas are built on one above the other, but most of its roof is ruined. On the wall opposite to the garbhagriha, a Jain image is carved. Besides this temple, other temples like Jyotirlinga, Siddheshwara and Mallikarjuna are found at Aihole. At the distance of half a mile from Aihole, the Ramalinga temple, which consists of 3 garbhagrihas, is built. Next is the cave temples of Badami. The cave temples of Badami were built by Chalukyas. 4 cave temples are even out of a huge rock. Its pillar, corridor and sculpture on the roof bear testimony of their perfection in art and sculpture. Let's know about the first cave temple. It is carved out of rock in the hill. It is the Shiva temple. It is 42 feet wide, 20 feet long and 15 feet high. There are 4 pillars in the veranda and 8 pillars in the interior hall. Tandava Nataraja figures is carved in the central hall. Lingas are carved on the either sides of the steps. Figures of Mahishasura Mardini and Ardhanarishvara are carved on the either side of Nataraja. There are sculptures of Ganapati, five-headed serpent, dancing, Gandharvas and episodes of Shiva Leela in the cave. This first cave temple can be called Nataraja temple. Next, the second cave temple. It is 60 feet long, 33 feet wide and 15 feet high. There are carvings of Trivikrama, Varaha, Vamana and other Dashavataras of Vishnu. Therefore, it is called Dashavataras of cave temple. Third cave temple. It is a Vaishnava temple. The main sculpture is that of Vishnu, which have 5-headed serpent over his head. There are figures of Lakshmi, Bhudevi, Garuda, Narasimha, Vamana, Varaha, Harihara, etc. Right side is Shiva and left side is Vishnu. Next is the fourth cave temple. It is a Jain temple. It is also called Meghana Basadi. It has the statue of Bahubali in the central hall. There are figures of Parshvanatha, Jain Yakshis. There is also a figure of Gautama, disciple of Mahavira. All these 4 cave temples were carved in 6th century AD. These have been regarded as the earliest cave temples in the South India. The third are the Vishnu Vaishnava caves and the fourth one is Parshvanatha, the Jain cave temples. This is the smallest of the 4. Next is Sangameshwara temple. It is in Pattadakallu. It was built in 725 AD. This was built by Chalukyan Emperor Vijayaditya. It is in Dravidian style of architecture. There are carvings of Shiva, Vishnu, Gajasura on the outer wall. Dwarapalakas at the entrance are very beautiful. This temple is a symbol of Shiva Vishnu harmony during the Chalukyan period. Next is Galaganatheshwara temple, which was built in 750 AD. It is another magnificent temple at Pattadakallu. It is in Nagara style. There is a huge kalasha in the shape of garlic. There is a sculpture of Shiva killing Andhakasura. Lions are carved on the pillar. A beautiful Shivalinga is installed in the sanctorium. Next is Virupaksha temple. It is in Pattadakallu. The important place where the Chalukyan art flourished is Pattadakallu. The Virupaksha temple is quite a famous one. This was built by Loka Mahadevi in the memory of the victory of her husband Vikramaditya II over the Pallavas. This was built on the model of Kaila Shishwara temple at Kanchi. There is a huge Nandi Mantapa in the front of temple. There is a figure of Surya in the roof of the temple. The art, according to the Professor Percy Brown, a great art critic, Virupaksha temple is the most attractive temples in Dravidian style. Chief architectures of this temple are Anivarata Gunda and Sarva Siddhi Acharya. There is a row of beautiful elephants at the bottom of the temple. The temple seems to rest on the head of lions. The beam inside the temple rests on elephant. It faces the east and measures 224 feet into 105 feet. There are two main entrances at the east and the west. And in the front, you can find the Nandi Mantapa. On either side of the big platform, there are two Garbhagrahas or sanctuariums. Next is the main Garbhagraha, where Shivalinga is installed with a Pradakshina Patha. Above, there is a Shikara, built in a Dravidian style. Its art and sculptures are revealed through many images carved on the outer wall, are highly admirable. Next, let us know about Mallikarjuna temple. It is in Pattadakallu. This was built by Trailokya Mahadevi, the second queen of Vikramaditya II. This was built in memory of victory over Pallavas of Kanchi. It is in Dravidian style. Its wall and pillars have a rich carvings related to Shiva Purana. Next, let us know about sculpture. The architects and sculptures played a major role in the construction of temples. Some of the important Chalukyan sculptures were Anivarathacharya Gunda, Sarvasiddhi Acharya, Revadi Ovoja, Paka, Arya Minchi Upadhyaya, Narasoja, Kappulappa, Changama, Baladeva, Aditya, Arya Minchi, Ganaraja and others. Virupaksha temple was designed and carved by the chief architect Anivaratha. He was assisted by Sarvasiddhi Acharya, Changama, Kappulappa and others. Papanatha temple of Pattadakallu was designed and carved by Revadi Ovoja. Sangameshwara temple was designed by Paka, Baladeva, Aditya, Changama and Kappulappa. Malagithi Shiva temple at Badami was carved by Arya Minchi Upadhyaya. Achmalli temple, Durga temple were carved by Narasoja and Ganasoja. The names of these sculptures are carved on the walls of the temple. They designed beautiful pillars, carved stone windows, jaladars, dwarapalakas, etc. That's all for today. In the next class, let's learn about Rashtrakutas. Thank you.